At HL, we want to help you make money. We can't guarantee you'll make millions, but we can give you everything you need to save and invest with confidence. Let's start with the basics. This is Andy. He has cash set aside for a rainy day, but wants to make the rest of his money work harder for him. So, what options does he have? Andy could keep all his cash in the bank and get a small amount of interest. The bank can afford to pay him interest because they lend his money out to businesses, who borrow because they think they can use the loan to expand their business and make more money. The banks are happy to lend the money because they are confident the business will do well. But because there's a risk the business could fail to repay the loan, the bank charges them a higher rate of interest to borrow the money than they give Andy for saving his money. This is how a bank makes a profit. So although it's Andy's money making this all possible, his savings aren't working as hard for him as they could. The good news is, Andy can get in on the action. If he owned part of the business, he could benefit from its success. If a company chooses, it can divide its ownership into hundreds of thousands of pieces, and those pieces, known as stocks or shares, can be bought and sold by the public through the stock market. When the business is doing well, it can choose to share its profits with shareholders like Andy. This is called a dividend. The value of Andy's shares generally reflects how much the company is worth, so he also benefits from the company's growth. Although, if the company performs poorly, the value of his shares could also fall, and if the company goes bust, he could lose all his money. Alternatively, instead of buying shares, Andy can cut out the bank and loan his money to the business directly. The company issues a bond, which is a promise to repay a loan, with a set interest rate over a fixed period of time. Andy doesn't benefit from the company's profits like when he owned shares, but as long as it can still repay its loan, he's less affected if the business struggles. Although, if the business fails to repay the loan, he could lose some or all of his money. By investing in shares, Andy has the most opportunity to grow his money, but its value will go up and down more than in bonds or cash. Putting all his money into a single company share is high risk, as Andy is completely dependent on its success. A fund buys shares in lots of companies, so gives Andy a way to spread that risk. Andy benefits from the combined performance, so is less affected by individual company success or failure.